everything won't be the same. Everything won't go your way. Neither will I let petty things change my mood. If you were wondering how I felt inside, I'll fall in love with you every day. Every moment you spend with me, it's not a waste of time. And give you all that I got.
Shelly,
Shelly, I don't wanna give you up.
Shelly,
Shelly, I wanna show you the whole world.
Shelly,
Shelly, in case you didn't know, I'm falling in love. I'm falling in love.
Shelly, when I won't. When I won't, nah, Shelly.
A late night phone call just to say I love you makes it worth the while. Gives me a reason to smile. When I'm alone without you, it's a breath of fresh air. Even when you're not here, no intentions of doubt. Let me down. Look at me. Tell me, what do you see? And don't be afraid. This is what he said to me.
Shelly,
yeah.
I don't wanna give you up.
Shelly,
Shelly,
I wanna show you the whole world.
Shelly,
Shelly, in case you didn't.
I'm falling in love. I'm falling in love. Shelly, when I'm
baby, let me give you more. Oh, baby, let me give you more. Give you all that I got to show you. Show you I love you, baby. Let me give you more, give you all that I got to show you that I love you. Oh, 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 Shelly.
I don't wanna give you up,
Shelly.
I wanna show you the whole world, Shelly. I'm falling in love,
Shelly.
I don't wanna give you up,
Shelly,
Shelly. I wanna show you the whole world,
Shelly,
Shelly.
In case you didn't know,
I'm falling in love,
I'm falling in love,
Shelly, when I won't. When I won't,
nah,
Shelly.
Nice there. Thanks. I got kind of memorized with me. That was so backlash from me singing there. Okay.
Yeah.
Miss Cassiano, this is part two for you. Tell me what's going on with you. Tell me your new projects.
Well, right now I am working on an album, a neo soul R&B album. I've been in the studio recording. Mm-hmm. I do have a few songs done. Just trying to perfect everything. Just bringing a new sound. Trying something different. Just trying to be more creative. Okay. Finding myself as an artist, yes. Which I have, and I love it. You know, playing instruments, learning how to play more instruments. I do want to produce my own music,
okay.
I've been taking guitar lessons and just piano and, yeah.
You do guitar and you do piano now, also?
I am learning more for of the guitar. I do know the basics and just kind of like writing more songs. It's definitely more helpful as an artist to learn and know how to play instruments, because that way, especially if you're a songwriter, it helps a lot with that.
Okay.
And producing your own music, just, you know, it helps you be more creative and, you know, be more artistic with your music, and just kind of like trying different instruments and see what different sounds sound like, you know, being more original.
Okay.
That's what I want.
All right, now we're gonna go from now to the back. So tell me how you started in this field, and tell me how you grew from when you first started. Tell me the influence of that.
I grew from when I first started, when I started doing more shows, I started challenging myself more. I was just doing a lot of research on my music, listening to a lot of old school. My father had passed away, so he left a lot of his like music behind. He was always big on listening to music, so he would chill out and listen to his jazz, his Marvin Gaye or his Al Green, and you know, some Anita Baker, some Karen White, or you know, Donna Summer, and you know, John Legend, you know, a lot of stuff like that. And you know, he left all that behind, and I started listening to a lot of his music, and it just helped me to become and have my mindset where it is right now and trying to learn more music.
Okay, that's good. So your father's like Al Green's and Anita Baker's, so that you get the neo soul kind of sound.
I've also been, I listen to a lot of jazz. You know, I write poetry.
Wow, so you kind of jack of all trades now, huh?
I've always written poetry. Like, I'm very big on that.
Okay.
It's meditating. It helps me put my feelings down.
So, culturally, I guess you get it from your background, maybe?
What?
What exactly your culture is, your culture? Where you come from?
Haiti.
So Shelly's like a Haitian
girl. Shelly's like my love, beautiful, sweetheart.
Okay, all right.
Yeah.
So I know you're proud.
Yeah.
I know you're proud. Okay, I like hearing that. Okay, so give me a background. From your roots. We first started, beginning. What makes you, from that little girl, want to sing all your life there, when it started to say, I'm going to sing? How did it come?
I started singing as a little girl, young, very young. My aunt. My mother's sister told me that when I was about maybe four or five years old, I used to run around the house singing Toni Braxton under Unbreak My Heart.
Wow.
And then after that, when I came to America, I always sang as a little girl, but where it really started was in church. And I sang in the church choir, and I grew up in the church,
So a lot of things come from church. How they come to church and they boom.
Absolutely.
Wow, okay, all right.
That's a God-given gift right there.
For
me was to have this voice, yes.
You were born with it, though. It came from natural.
Yeah.
You're born, okay. All right, so what makes you, so for you, a little girl in the church, you start from church. How about school? But did you do it in school, too?
I sang in the chorus. I sang at school, in the choir at school.
Yeah. So everything starts from little on up. Mm-hmm. So this is like your destiny to be a singer.
Yeah, middle school. I sang in the middle school choir. I sang in high school, the choir, at church in the choir. I was in a lot of musical programs. I was in writer's block. Went to a little acting school when I was a little girl. I actually wrote two of my my scripts.
What? Yeah.
I wrote one. One was about the sun. And people, and then the other one was about a man in a chair.
Man in a chair.
Yeah. So like this was when I was about 11 years old, and it's at the Guard Art Theater downtown in London. It was like a little acting class that we had taken, and we had to write our own scripts. Yeah. So it was challenging as an 11-year-old, but I was so excited about it. You know, I was so creative, because when you're young, you just write about anything. Yeah, you know, I was happy that I did that, but it was more about, you know, someone sitting on the chair and the chair's getting tired of being taken advantage of type thing. And then, you know, the person sitting on the chair and the chair's like, why don't you clean me, get off me, let me breathe, you know.
He was a chair. Wow. Okay. Yeah. It could be a major movie, you know. Like, I mean, they did one like The Phone Booth. So yeah. Why not The Chair?
Yeah.
It could be major. I said, hey, keep writing that script. You could add a little stuff to it. Never know.
Yeah.
Wow, that's good to see stuff in that. So you always been in entertainment, you always been in that kind of field, but you ain't really focus it to win. You got the, I'm like, okay, you got this going on with the writing scripts, you're doing singing. What made you really like, you know, well, I could do more than this. I could really push myself. What made you push that extra oomph?
It's just that, just the love of the music that I have. Like, I just love music. I love to sing. I love the beauty of music. Like I told you, I write poetry, and listening to a lot of music uh-huh. and a lot of inspiration that I've had with past artists, you know, big artists as far as like Anita Baker, uh-huh. you know, Mary J. Blige, Lauryn Hill, uh-huh. Amy Winehouse, Mariah Carey, Donna Summer, Karen White, uh-huh. you know, those ladies, it's, oh yeah, I can't forget her, Miss Tina Turner.
Uh-huh. Okay, the leg.
I love
the
Tina Turner.
Lady.
Yeah.
Leg lady, yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Those, just growing up and singing in the house all the time and singing a lot of their songs and just, you know, I recorded my first studio session at 12 years old. And right then and there, that's when it really started to.
Uh-huh.
And then, you know, from there, I just kept building up and just challenging myself and trying to be better and finding my voice, finding my image, finding yeah. myself. And, uh-huh. you know, a lot of obstacles as a young adult growing up,
well,
but...
Yeah, well, what kind of obstacles you as a young adult? I mean, what kind of obstacles you didn't cross and you passed? What obstacles you had that you like, damn, I can get over this obstacle because they hold me back? Or what kind of obstacles?
A lot of things, you know, just peer pressure and, mm-hmm. and school and just home life and just trying to find yourself as a young adult. It's mm-hmm. just, that's hard in itself, you yeah. know? And, you know, music helped me with that. Mm. It helped me a lot with that. And I try to stay in a lot of positive things. You know, after school programs, musical after school programs, and things like that, and coming home and writing music. I didn't really, you know, go out like that and watch TV that much. I was yeah. in my room writing songs, uh-huh. rewriting songs, yeah. you know, it's what I used to do.
So you never had nobody like your friend, like, you can't sing, or you won't be like that?
I've had that.
You proved them wrong now, didn't you?
I mean, I got along. I still have some ways to go. You know, I'm not satisfied. I feel like I can definitely be better, mm-hmm. and I want to be better. I want to be more creative. I want to challenge myself more because mm-hmm. I know I can be better. So, and I want to let young women know that as well.
Okay. Yeah. So, I mean, as an artist, is it easy? Is it the thing? Was you shy? I mean, how do you get to start singing like that? Crowds, you know, people. Like, there's another part of you, like Beyonce, got an alter ego. Yeah. What's your alter ego name? What's your alter ego name? Everybody got an alter ego or something that they get out there, like, fierce Beyonce.
Name is Black Madonna.
Black Madonna. Okay. Okay, so you perform your name now, you're Black Madonna, alter ego.
Yeah.
Okay.
Black Madonna.
That comes out of you, all right. Is you a shy person beside that thing? Are you shy? Besides this?
I'm a very friendly, person. I try to look at everybody's view from their eyes. You know, mm-hmm. like that. I'm not judging or, you know, I just try to be kind and be humble mm-hmm. and just really understand. My view of life is, I feel like I'm like out there.
Mm-hmm.
Cause I don't feel like I look at life in the world mm-hmm. as like everybody else.
Yeah. Now I know Haitian backgrounds, they kind of strict.
Yeah.
No, I dealt with some people from Haiti here. Yeah, their background kind of strict. Their parents kind of strict on them doing things. So how they feel about you singing?
Actually, I respect my culture mm-hmm. and I respect Haitian people and mm-hmm. you know my Haitian family. Mm-hmm. I have a lot of Haitian friends.
Mm-hmm.
Growing up in America, coming to America as such a young girl, mm-hmm. it's just a different type of life, different environment mm-hmm. to get used to, and you know you get Americanized and you forget about your culture. Mm-hmm. I don't want to do that. Mm-hmm. I don't like that. I want to represent where I came from.
Okay.
That's my culture, not my religion, but, yeah. you know, just who my nationality, just okay. it's what I am.
Okay.
And I don't ever want to lose that.
What's your favorite, what's your favorite food?
My favorite food, you talking about Haitian food?
Uh-huh.
Sospois, you know, uh-huh. piclis,
uh-huh.
That's mostly what it is. Bunnan, I love Bunnan.
Oh, yeah?
Bunnan and Pekleys, yeah.
Oh, yeah? What exactly, explain what is that for the people that
That's plantains and like a spice, kind of like a, it's cabbage pretty much.
Uh-huh.
It's kind of like, you ever had coleslaw from Popeyes?
I hate mayonnaise.
It's not like that though. But uh-huh. It's homemade.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's not mayonnaise. Uh-huh. There's no like anything in there like that. It's just like a seasoned, and then you just dip the plantains in there, and it tastes really good.
Okay. See, so you should,
there's a little spice in it.
You start doing commercials.
Little vinegar.
Start doing jingle singing for the commercials. The food part. You're saying it gets better. Yeah, you try that also, you know. Yeah, I tell you, isn't that? You do commercials, jingles for the commercials, man.
I do want to do commercials one day.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, I'm telling you, that's where it is.
I want to do commercials. I want to sing for commercials.
Yeah,
I want to be the actual person who does the commercials.
Do that because I do commercials for a bean pie person.
Really?
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah, do that commercial thing.
Yeah.
All right, that's good. That's at least in a lot of areas.
Yeah.
Okay, I got to ask you another question. In your past areas singing, have you had anybody that you think that inspired you, that beside the other area there, but really, really, you say, I want to be like that person. I want to be like that person in a couple of years from now. Or I'm that person now. Do you see anybody that really, one person, not many, but one, you think you see yourself 5 years from now being like?
Alicia Keys.
Alicia Keys?
I love Alicia Keys. She's so talented.
Mm-hmm.
She's so original.
Yeah.
She plays instruments. She does her own thing. She has her own personality. She's creative. You know, she's her. She has her head on her shoulders.
Mm-hmm.
She's a strong woman.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I like.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I want to be.
Mm, okay.
Now, you know, I have my own style and my own ways as an artist.
Yeah.
But as far as someone that is very inspirational to me, just as far as womanhood,
mm-hmm.
I respect Alicia Keys. And I do see myself being as successful as she is.
Okay.
You know.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, for the first second we have with you, a while back. How do you see yourself grown from last time, and what changed in the last part one we had of you, in the first show we had, as an artist? What changed from that first artist to now? What made a difference?
Just growing as a person, just viewing life differently. Oh my God, I don't want to get emotional, but my dad was sick. He had cancer, and you know, just being around him and having conversations with him, because I always spoke to him all the time.
Yeah.
And he was a person that I went to when I needed advice.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, after he passed away, it's just my eyes just really, really opened up to a lot of things. And it's just like now I still feel him speaking to me in certain ways and, you know, certain situations and, you know, problems or even my music, you know. Just when I listen to some of the songs or some of the CDs or the records that he used to listen to around the house, like, and I feel his presence and I feel his you know, spiritual presence, and it's just helpful. And it actually really motivates me to write my music,
mm-hmm.
just thinking about him and just knowing how good of a person he was. Like that right there, that touches me. And that's why I feel like now is the time to really, really do something.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like one of my biggest inspirations.
Yeah. Okay, that's good. That's good.
Yeah.
That's good. Well, it's very nice. That's good.
Yeah.
So do you see yourself maybe in the future, producing other artists, or see yourself producing other artists maybe?
I do. But right now, me as an artist myself,
uh-huh.
I need to get out there.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
So what's your main focus? I mean, music wise. I knew you're neo, so the neo soul, right?
Yeah.
Okay. You have to about doing like other areas like rap rock or R&B. Do you want to elevate? I mean, you want to stay right there? You want to go everywhere? How do you want to stay?
I'm very versatile.
Uh-huh.
I like all types of music, uh-huh. and I sing a lot of everything.
Mm-hmm.
But the neo soul, I want to bring a new version of that.
Okay.
You know, neo soul is always gonna be neo soul, the jazz sound, the, you know, cultural, spiritual, just
mm-hmm.
especially like Erykah Badu, India Arie, you know, music soul child,
that's
D'Angelo,
what I want to hear.
All those people,
so,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They've also inspired me as well.
Mm-hmm.
I want to bring a little bit of a umph to it, you know,
mm-hmm.
a newer version to it. So this album that I'm working on, which, you know, I'm going all out. That's okay. It. I'm just going to go all out.
So what name of your album?
I can't tell you that yet.
Okay.
I haven't made a decision. You can't put me on the spot.
Oh, okay. All right.
Let's go.
Okay, all right. All right. So you record that. Okay. But your song, neo soul songs, right?
Mm. Neo soul, R&B, soul. R&B. You know.
So explain, because people don't understand what exactly is that neo soul? What makes a neo soul?
It's digging real deep into a musical. Mm-hmm. Just music, just the beauty of music, mm-hmm. just the sound, just individual instruments, just jazz, you know, mm-hmm. the saxophone, violin, or, you know, just the drums, especially the drums, you know, just a lot of stuff like that. I just love the beauty of every instrument and the mm-hmm. sound. Mm-hmm. And a lot of the culture from neo soul is coming from that. Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of original music mm-hmm. is from neo soul.
Okay.
I that's how I feel, okay. You know, and you know, R&B as well. They're both, you know, the same, you know, as far as music, a lot of originality to R&B and mm-hmm. neo soul mm-hmm. it needs to come back pretty much. That's how I feel.
Okay.
I feel like it needs to come back. So,
okay. So what do you think about a lot of, give me an artist that really you think could did better and didn't do better. Out there right now, do you think right now? Give me an artist that you, but you got what artist? Alicia Keys. You have artists.
Alicia Keys is always gonna be fantastic, okay. Amazing. You know.
What other artists that never get praised that you think are really good that don't get much airplay? You think is out there now that you think?
Honestly, I like Grace.
Grace.
I like her music.
Okay.
You know, right now that's how I feel. I was listening to her album, and she's pretty dope.
Okay.
But, you know, every artist is different. They have their own fan base. Mm-hmm. They have their own people that like their type of music. Mm-hmm. So I just feel like R&B needs to come back.
Yeah.
And that's my focus. And okay. I want to be that artist to bring that back.
Okay. Now, yeah. You know, as artists, a lot of times people like to change stuff. Now, what about you that nobody can ever change about you?
They can never change me because I'm always going to be original. I'm always going to be, this is me.
Okay.
And how I speak in my music is really me. How I write my music is really me and life experiences. Mm-hmm. Things that I see, things that I go through, you know, with people. It's just love, heartbreaks, mm-hmm. life situations. That's never going to change about me.
Okay.
You know.
Now, if you look back in your past, and you know a lot it's about relationships.
Right.
Okay, you want to give, how you say it, F you to those, my past relationship who did me wrong and then I was singing this song there? You want to give a finger up to somebody?
No, I think that every relationship has its lessons that you learn from.
Uh-huh.
You make mistakes, you learn from that, and uh-huh. you move on, and you remember not to make those same mistakes.
Okay.
You know.
That's pretty grown up.
There's no... You okay. didn't. You can't say that because at some point you loved that person, you really cared about them, and they were a friend,
okay.
You know? So if you got your heart broken, it didn't work out, hey.
Okay, so you're...
It is what it is, so but you learn from it, and you will move on to the next.
Okay. Yeah. That's good. Very good. Most people are like, this, you know, give a finger up to this guy. That's all right. You can be very, very grown up about it. That's nice.
That's hate, and I don't like to hate.
That's right.
I'm a very loving person.
That's right. That's good.
I don't.
Hate is not good anyway, because waste of emotion. It's a waste of emotion, you know. So hate is like you're doing good and doing your thing. Not like, man, I shouldn't did it to him. Now I wish I was there with him. He's hard out now. He's like, damn, look at this. I messed up. That was him. Too late now. That's a good thing. You're showing what you're emotion about. Like, what do you like to do on your spare time? What is you? Without the singing, anything else? What do you like to do? On your spare time. Your spare time. Just you, Cassiana, regular person, chilling out, hanging out with your friends. What do you like to do?
Hanging out when I hang out with my friends?
Yeah. What you like to do? Just relax. What do you do? Start singing. Here's something about this.
It doesn't have anything to do with singing. No. It's just something that I do with my friends.
Yeah. What you like to do? Besides
all that? Go out. Have a good time.
What you do?
You know.
Bowling? Moving shoe pool? What? What you like to do?
I like to go to the museum.
Wow. Okay.
I'm just kidding. No, stop.
No, seriously. That's called, I like that. I go to museums. That's good.
No, I like bowling.
Okay.
You know, going out, you know, dancing.
Okay.
With my friends.
Okay.
Even just hanging out at the house, like, that's cool, too.
Yeah, because I want to know what's natural about what Kathy had. Beside the singing part, we know about the singing part, but beside that, the artist itself, what does she like to do?
On my quality time?
Yeah.
I don't want to be around anyone, honestly. I like to be alone.
Well, okay, you're a loner.
I like to be alone and just write my poetry, you know, maybe watch a movie or two, listen to some music, light my candles, throw on some jazz or some of my dad's old records. Like, that's what I do.
Okay, so you're introvert, like being this by yourself.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, all right, well, that's what you like to do. We got a couple of people, but no, you know, figure, in a spot, you got like, you know, with spare time, movies, go biking, well, you know, shoot pool, you know what I'm saying? Cause I don't even sing, because I do the same thing. My areas, hey, be about to chill, relax,
some
you know?
Pool, so you like to shoot pool?
Yeah, shoot pool.
I suck at that.
I shoot pool, you know what I'm saying? I go bike, I do my bike thing, ride. I was thinking about a truck.
I do want a Harley one day.
Harley, okay.
Yeah.
I see you rocking a Harley. I can see you rocking a Harley.
I do. I want a Harley.
All right. So you put that. I can see you doing a Harley thing.
Yeah.
I can see that. I've been saying some of the singing part you need your dad for yourself because there's two people. See, like me, there's two people. Like you got two people. You the singer, and you the producer, and also you the person. Without all the lights, all the cameras. What do your favorite stuff yourself to do? This is you by yourself, nobody else like to do.
Well, actually, I just wanted, you know, as far as me producing right now, I'm not at that stage yet where I'm producing for myself.
But you are up here.
In my mind, yes, absolutely.
So that's the first.
I think of a lot of
you know
sounds
what you like.
And beats and,
see?
You know, all types of things. And I bring that attention to the producers that I do work with. Shout out to Trinity Tech, by the way. Henry Smith. I love you guys. My life
made
a little bit better.
See that? See? All right, coming out.
So, you know, I'm not there with producing yet for myself. You know, I'm learning the instruments that I have started to, you know, that's going to transition to me where I get to a place where I can, you know, start producing my own music, which is my one of a goal that I have right now. So.
You do your thing. I say, I mean, I have a certain time period. You're like, yo, I'm singing 24/7. I'm writing. I just want to sit back and relax for a day. So, give me some Goya with the Maltas, relax. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Bring my little cooking, my kitchen, and chill. But this is what I like to do. I don't hear no phone call, but the music. Don't call me this one. I just want to do this. This is my time.
Yeah.
My time, nothing else. I'm sure I get that part. You know, it's your time.
Is it weird that I like to watch Animal Planet?
No. Well, weird. Nah. I mean, that's good stuff. I see an Animal Planet sometimes get chewed up. I see a couple of animals.
Yeah.
Ain't no wrong with that.
I mean, what's wrong with trying to stay educated?
Ain't that nothing. That's a good thing.
Absolutely.
I like that. I watch the Animal Planet, my History Channel. I do all that stuff.
I'm
a little geeky too. I have a problem. No problem. We all a little geek sometimes. I'm a little bit like that too.
Yep.
I still watch all that stuff, science novels and History Channel. I'm deep in CNN political areas.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm a politician guy.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm deep in that. You know what I'm saying? And my little car, I also like my Marvel comics.
Right.
I'm versatile.
Yeah.
I watch Marvel Thomas, Flash, all that stuff. Supernatural.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Hey, I do all this stuff. So then I go do my CNN. So I understand that. Mm-hmm. You know, nah, it's good. It's good. That'll be getting somewhere. All right.
Yep.
So what about Animal Planet like? What about Animal Planet you like watching too?
I don't know. Just
we want to get to know you.
Some of the things that, you know, they learning new animals and what their environment and how they adapt to new environments. And, you know, this is a lot about you as a person too. How can you adapt to a new environment?
Okay.
Some animals are getting extinct because, you know, it's just a lot of stuff. Just, get me started on that.
Let me go to the company and talk about it. Now, what about that extinction? Tell me about it. Tell me, animals get extinct. What do you think? What about? Tell me about it.
I feel like animals make our world.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Why do you say that?
Because God created them.
Oh, yeah? Okay. All right. So
this is God's world. Okay. He created the world. He created you. He created me.
Oh.
So I don't think it's fair.
That's a whole nother subject, but.
No, it's not. I grew up in the church. I believe in God 100%.
And that's the next show.
Absolutely. I'm a child of God. So,
I got to keep my thoughts right down for that one.
That's where the animal planet comes in, because this is God's creation, you know. So.
Okay, I can say nothing about that. I can say nothing about that show. Y'all know what I'm talking about. So I can say nothing about that. This is your show today.
Oh, God.
This is your show. So I can say nothing about that right now. Okay, apple planet, it's a good thing. Okay, so creation animals, extinction. All right. So what's your favorite animal?
My favorite animal? Actually, I have a few. Uh-huh. Can I just name them?
You can name them, yeah.
I love leopards.
Why?
Because they're so beautiful, they're so calm. They have their own little, small little community, their own little area. You know, leopards, jaguars, lions, tigers, and bears. Oh my! Yeah.
I know that was coming. That was coming. I know that was coming.
No, I'm just kidding.
That was coming.
No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding. I like eagles,
uh-huh.
Because they can see more than anybody else.
Okay. So I like nosy people. Eagles.
Yeah.
Okay, all right.
Pretty much. I like, you know, leopards, eagles, dogs. I like dogs.
Okay, yeah?
Yeah. I like all animals. I think all animals have their own, you know, their own thing.
What's the most powerful animal you think, and also the smartest one combined?
The most powerful and strongest?
And smartest one.
And smartest.
Intelligent one. Animal.
I'm going to go with an eagle.
Mm-hmm.
They're very powerful. They can fly up high and they still see you, no matter how high they go.
They're about to get extinct, don't they?
I don't like that.
Yeah.
Who do I need to speak to about that? Because I'm not feeling that. I don't like eagles going bye-bye.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, they definitely get extinction in that problem area.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's one of their main areas, is extinction area. Okay. The eagles?
I do like eagles. I think eagles are the strongest and smartest mentally.
Okay.
You know, lions are big. But I like elephants, too.
They don't forget.
They don't.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. And they're very kind, very gentle.
Yeah.
I like elephants.
Okay. So you're an animal person.
I mean, I don't have any animals of my own. I mean, I do have a cat at home.
Yeah.
But my mom and I share him, so.
Oh, yeah? Little cat. What kind of cat you got?
He's just a regular cat. His name is Hamilton.
A cat named Hamilton?
Yeah.
He kind of snobby?
He's orange. He actually looks like Garfield. Yeah.
A Garfield cat. Wow, that's cute.
That is cute.
That's cute.
He's very cute.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's good. At least we know you're an animal person. All right? We got that out the way. Okay,
yeah.
We got the food. So we got to know a lot about you. Everybody want to know this about this cat.
And I do believe in education 100%.
Oh, really?
I'm actually graduating college next month.
There you go.
Hey!
There you go. What's your major?
I'm going to be, well, I got hired out of my internship, so I'm a dental tech.
Uh-uh. Yeah. Oh, I can't remember. Start smiling. Stop smiling.
Let me see your teeth. I'm just kidding. I'm kidding.
I just had some spaghetti. It looked good, a little garlic on the side, you know, looking out of the corner. So
I do believe in education a lot.
Okay.
I do. It's very important to me.
That's good. Not only do you sing, but you're intelligent as well.
Yeah.
That's good. Now, I'll get your political views. We don't know your political. You gotta get there.
You gotta get you
like that. Now, we got some situations. See, I know you're singing, because see, part of music, you're singing passionate feeling. I know that's coming out soon. About most good artists sing about political areas. That's bringing or breaking. A lot of people is divided between this one and this one. Now, we got some situations.
Mm-hmm.
We got some major situations in the country right now dealing with these two people.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? What are your political views on what we got now with this arena of politics?
I think the world is changing drastically.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I think it's has a big effect on the youth. It's, you know, it's just all the changes, all the violence that has been going on.
Mm-hmm.
careless behavior. You know, the deaths of in the communities, the bombings in the schools. I mean, I don't like that. You know, I don't like that. You got kids going to school trying to be educated and got to lose their life for what, you know? You know, I don't believe in violence, and I most certainly don't believe in, you know, being prejudiced. I don't support judgment. I don't support, you know, just hateness. There's just people being hateful. You know, but there's always a deeper reason why. There's always a deeper reason why people get like that. You know, it's like this. Once somebody is telling you, I need, I need, I need, and they keep asking and saying, I need, I need. After a while, they're not gonna say, I need anymore. They're gonna say, I want, I'm coming to get it. And then that's it. They get tired of being nice, they get tired of being patient, they get tired of asking, then they're just gonna go get it. You know, and that's, I think that's what the world is coming to, is just everybody's being treated differently. Nobody feels like they're being treated fairly. You know, we got all types of changes going on around, and it's just, it's affecting everybody. I feel like it's a depression now. I wanna be an uplift for that.
See, that's singers. I'll be glad we got you saying, because singers help people feel better.
Absolutely.
Listen, I tell you straight up, you know, my political areas, we got the Trumps. You know, I'm like, you got Trumps going to, I know Hillary. You know what? You got, like, we got a lot of problems in this country. And you look at both arenas, like, you know what? They ain't going to make it better. Trump doesn't gonna make it, they're not going to make it better.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I'm looking at big arena, like, what you got to choose from? You know what I'm saying? Oh, we get Hillary? I get Hillary over Trump. Ain't like I want to. But she's the best of both evils. You know? So political venue is very, very powerful for singers. They got some singers going from every area who they backing. You know what I'm saying? It's a very powerful arena. Politics is very powerful.
It is very powerful.
You gotta look at like what's benefiting most areas. As a singer, where do you see yourself, I say political areas, venues, you support more than politics areas?
Venues? You know, like
sing venues, who actually sing, who you think you will go more to support as a singer?
As somebody who's an upcoming president or
something? Give your views on the politics area. Give your views on it.
Honestly, you know, I don't really like speaking upon that, you know? I'm not really into that. So I just, I like to focus on my music, you know, and just chill out and just block all that out. You know, all of that that's going on around me, I block all that out and I write it down.
That's good for feelings. I got this song back called I ain't gonna go to war for no bush. I did a song like that. You know what I'm saying? I'm more like the Animal Tiger guy. A very vocalist person.
Now, if I sat there and everything that was going on around me, if I would let it affect me, I'd be a hateful person too. And I don't want to be that way.
That's a good thing. Your soul has got that soul. We like hearing that. We like hearing that soulful area. You uplift us, see?
That's what I want. I want to uplift people with my music.
We need that.
Because you never know what somebody's going through. You never know how you can inspire someone.
And change people's lives. I like that.
Yeah.
So you got any upcoming events coming up? Any events you want to tell us about, the upcoming events you got? Or any areas you want to speak upon? About upcoming events you
I
got?
I do want to speak more about my album that I'm working on, the Neo Soul album.
Yeah, speak on that.
Trying to be more creative with that.
Let me want
to
hear about.
And you know, as far as my music, if people want to hear, I am on YouTube.
Give it to you. Tell me your YouTube channel.
I'm on Instagram, Kathiana Music. I am on Twitter, Kathiana Music. Facebook, Kathiana Music, and I'm also on YouTube, Kathiana, and SoundCloud, Kathiana.
Okay. I want you to spell it out to him. Spell it out to him.
KATHIANNA for YouTube and SoundCloud, and KATHIANNA Music for Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.
There you go. See, I gotta let them know that. Cause I gotta put an extra N there, make sure. You know what I'm saying? That's my name I could this time. That's amazing. So that's gonna tell me the producer you work with. Talk about your producers you've been dealing with. Talk about your producers.
My producers are awesome.
You get the names, that's okay. You can shout them out.
Trinity Tech, Henry Smith, and Studio Mars.
Okay, yeah. So we'll make them awesome.
What makes them awesome is the time and the patience. Mm-hmm. It takes a lot to work with an artist. Mm-hmm. Artist is very picky. Mm-hmm. There's a certain sound they like.
Yeah.
When they're recording, the frustrations and trying to be more creative, and especially having love for music as much as they are.
Mm-hmm.
Having the love for music, you know? That takes a lot for a producer just to be able to feel out that artist. Mm-hmm. And, you know, being the fact that I worked with Trinity for a long time, mm-hmm. you know, he actually started mixing my music and produced one of my songs, and I hadn't even met him yet,
mm-hmm.
you know? And then when we did finally meet, it was just like, I already knew him for some reason, mm-hmm. you know? And I feel like I've grown and developed as an artist with him. Just, you know, the fact that he knew my type of style of music. You know, in the studio, mm-hmm. he was on it.
Yeah.
You know, now he was just on it because he supported, he believed in me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he spoke positivity to me at mm-hmm. my studio sessions, and he just worked very hard. And then now I'm working with Henry Smith at mm-hmm. Studio Mars, and he's awesome too.
Studio Mars, where's that located at?
It's in New London.
Where's New London at?
Connecticut.
Okay.
New London, Connecticut.
Because people don't know where, you know, over there.
Shout out to the Whalers, hey.
We New Yorkers. We try to find out where they're at, okay.
New London.
Okay. basically, back to you from the Connecticut area.
Yeah.
All right, Connecticut base. Okay, I hear you. I hear you, Connecticut. I hear you. All right. So Henry Smith and Tech.
Trinity Tech.
Other producer, another name you said.
Manny Lopes, I did work with him mm-hmm. as well. Just on two songs.
Uh-huh.
The first song that presented to the neo soul side of me
uh-huh.
is a song called "Save Me the Last Dance,"
uh-huh.
and that's out right now. There's a video of it on YouTube.
Say it.
"Save Me the Last Dance." It's on YouTube.
Uh-huh.
Under my name, KATHIANNA.
Okay.
It's called "Save Me the Last Dance."
Okay.
It's a very jazzy sound. It's
okay.
very different from the music that I was doing before. And that was like a big presentation to,
mm-hmm.
you know, what my style is about to be like.
Okay. All right. So you got a lot of different producers.
Yeah.
Okay, that's good. This will make you happy. That's the main thing, because I know an unhappy art is not good.
Yeah.
I dealt with one a long time ago
yeah.
when I first started in my music area. And one of my managers gave me this cat to produce. And little rah-rah guy, you know, you little on a little schizo kind of cat. In the studio, he didn't like the engineer, so he pulled a gun out. Now, mind you, I had a sixth sense. I told him, yo, don't even deal with this dude. But I didn't know that, see?
Mm-hmm.
In the studio, the cat pulled a gun out on an engineer. I, at one time, just started in the field. Looked at him like, yo, you out your mind, dude. I had to shake it down, because I just started. I ain't know about this area. Had to calm him down, take him to the studio, tell him, yo, you on your own. Because I didn't know about the area. Got to learn about artists sometimes. Beats was hot. We were doing music. My music was good, but the engineer got on his nerve. And he was a loose cannon. So I didn't.
See, what my thing with that is, you know, with the engineer getting on his nerves.
Yeah.
And, you know, honestly, me as an artist, you know, an engineer is very helpful when it comes to,
mm-hmm.
you know, when you're in your session.
Yeah.
Because they're the ones, me, I like to work with
mm-hmm.
my producer, my engineer, mm-hmm. by myself.
Mm-hmm.
Just me and them. It helps me focus more.
Mm-hmm.
You know, criticism is great, especially when you're in the studio working.
Mm-hmm.
You want that.
Yeah.
If you can't take criticism, it's just not for you.
And that was his problem.
But I mean, you never know what the real situation was with that. I can't speak on it because I wasn't there, but you know.
Well, I was in the studio with him. I was in the studio when it happened. That would got me mad. I was like, what? Because I was there. So, Ms. Cassiana, what do you want to say to the upcoming artists right now that you could give them good information on how to become, you know, a singer? What do you give some advice to them?
Believe in your music. Believe in what you love to do, you know, your art, being creative, and listening to music and learning the background of what music is really about. Like, you know, that'll help as an artist just developing into their own. Just being creative and staying humble and wanting and being hungry. And no matter what it is, don't let anybody tell you you can't do what you want to do. Continue. No matter what obstacles get in your way, keep going.
Okay. Well, I enjoyed this time interviewing you again, Ms. Castellano.
Yeah.
We're going to let it end this off with a nice song you're going to sing. And in the future, I'll be seeing you in the future.
Yes.
Thank you very much, ma'am, for coming.
Thank you.
And good for your inspiration for all the people out there. Yes. Ms. Claude Jones presents Ms. Castellano, star. Sing off, baby. Do your thing.
Thank you.
To see, there's no place that I'd rather be. You got me so far gone, and I can't leave you alone. Can you understand where I'm coming from? Save me the last dance. Oh. They say that I'm crazy, 'cause I fell in love with you rapidly. Well, maybe I am wrong, and I only dream of your love all the time. Ooh. Save me the last dance, baby. Save me the last dance. Save me the last dance, baby. Can you save me the last dance? Oh. Sweet, 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 touching me. Keep, and driving me insane. the last dance. Baby, can you save me the last dance? Save me the last dance. Save me the last dance. Baby, can you save me the last dance?